Hello and welcome again to Meridian Fight Night. In tonight's show, we feature some of the South's best fighters, and we're also heading to Las Vegas for a world title showdown. Well, Peterborough may not be renowned for its bright lights, but that's where an unbeaten super middleweight is spending his birthday, and he's hoping to land another impressive victory. Yes, birthday boy Steve Bendall from Bournemouth is top of the bill tonight. He hopes to celebrate by making it 11 wins from 11 starts. But Southampton's Peter Mitchell is aiming to spoil that party. Stay with us for this South Coast derby match. Paul Dyer from Portsmouth is also on tonight's card. After two defeats in 2000, welterweight Dyer attempts to get back on track against Paul Denton from Birmingham. Also tonight, we meet Chris Eubank. Yes, it's 10 years since he became world champion. He'll be sparring with reporter Gary Newborn later in the show. And we head for Las Vegas to see a battle between two of the world's toughest small fighters, the flyweights. And they have a big title at stake. And we have a heavyweight presence on the show this evening. Former British champion Julius Francis is our guest here in the studio tonight at the end of a dramatic year that began with Julius climbing into the ring with Iron Mike Tyson. We'll be chatting to him in just a moment. Well, Julius took Tyson to the second round of their heavyweight contest back in January, but those of you who were with us on Meridian Fight Night last month witnessed an astonishing world record, a knockout blow in just 2 seconds. Plymouth's Dead Sowden now holds the title of being knocked out in world record time by Welshman Russell Ducky Rees. Thankfully, Sowden recovered from that. Not surprisingly, he's decided to call it a day, and apparently he's returned to his job as a baker. Julius, it's the kind of thing, as far as a boxer concerned, it must be a nightmare. Just watch how this happens. It's kind of being stopped in your prime before the fight's even started.
Yeah, definitely. It was a great shot. It was a great shot, but is a big pity for the guy that gets connected with it, you know, and then having that on his record, 2 second stoppage, you know, it's not good.
Well, he's gone back to being a baker apparently. Maybe that's the best place.
Maybe,
for them.
Maybe.
And of course they got the headlines at the time.
Yeah, definitely. But then through something like that, the younger guys especially, they can take things like that and learn and use them as learning experience, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, it's the kind of headlines that you don't want really as part of
your career. Don't want them, but you can learn from them, though, you know?
We were quite pleased in a sense because it was on our particular card that night, and of course there it was in the papers the following day.
Yeah.
It knocks out in 2 seconds. It's astonishing.
Yeah.
Well, our first fight this evening features a boxer from the South who's been demolishing his opponents pretty swiftly. Steve Bendall from Bournemouth is a familiar face to Fight Night viewers.
For the broken hearted, a silent prayer for faith departed. And I ain't gonna be just a face in the crowd. You're gonna hear my voice when I shout it out loud. It's my
today is Bendall's 27th birthday. Will he be celebrating? His opponent this evening is Peter Mitchell from Southampton. It's a super middleweight contest scheduled to last 8 rounds. The Bushfield Sports Centre in Peterborough is the venue for tonight's boxing. We're going to join the contest at the beginning of the 4th round. Our commentators are Steve Bunce, but first, it's Graham Beecroft.
So round 4, not quite ready to come out. Peter Mitchell didn't have his gum shield in, so referee Green just waiting until that's sorted out.
Oh. It's at this point in a fight that you're controlling so totally that you have to decide, do you just perhaps step up the gear? And it's not a case of throwing caution to the wind. This is not the last round and you have to win by knockout. But do you try and stop the guy? Do you try and pick it up? Do you try a bit of variety?
Well, I think Bendel's decided to up it, and not a bad decision. He could go through this one, go through the motions and win it comfortably on points, no question about it. But it's all about pushing yourself at the same time, isn't it? And getting a real sweat up, getting a real workout on, and doing your very best. And that's what I think Bendall has decided he's going to do in this fourth round, to go for a little bit more, try and up the pace and see if Mitchell can stay with it. It's like a runner in a 10,000 metres, suddenly putting a spurt on, going out in front and seeing if your opponents can stay with you.
Also, it's a good sign that when you're fighting a man that's got a hamburger van in a car park in Southampton and he gets in the ring like he's been in Gran Canaria for 2 weeks of a suntan, that he's not been training solidly for 6 weeks.
Good work from Bendall. Punches spearing through that guard. Once again, snapping the punches in more, Bendall this time. Oh, good right from Bendall. He's got Mitchell in trouble here. Mitchell's in trouble on the ropes. Referee is looking, but he manages to hang on, Mitchell. Good work from Bendall. Good right again from Bendall. He's asking the questions, and at the moment, Mitchell only just getting the answers out in time, and he's bleeding from the nose. Oh, but he was caught with a big right there, Bendall, as well by Mitchell, an uppercut. All of a sudden, Bendall has changed the pace. Of Mitchell, a good left again from Bendall, banging into the face of Mitchell in the last 10 seconds of round four. And breathing heavily, Mitchell. End of the round, they tap gloves again, but there was, as Bendall goes back there, there was a great big breath of air from Mitchell. The fans like that one. They like what they saw there from Steve Bendall.
Good shots, that's why. Heard his man, called him a good shot. Didn't let him off the hook, but at the same time, didn't get too close. I don't think Mitchell once, throughout any of those exchanges, and they lasted almost the entire 3 minutes, I don't think once Mitchell was able to claim and grab hold of Bendall. You see, Bendall, everything is from a stand upright position. Good shots, never gets too close, always leaves himself some leverage, even if it's short shots inside or longer shots like that. He's always got some space, and it's possibly better to watch it from this overhead angle. Feet are perfect.
Good shots, nicely balanced. He took the punch as well, Mitchell, in fairness to him. Plenty would have gone down there, but he stuck in Peter Mitchell, and great credit to him for that. So round five then, scheduled for eight at super middleweight. Steve Bendall from Bournemouth, Peter Mitchell from Southampton in the red trunks. Bendall originally from Coventry and wearing the sky blue shorts of Coventry City. Previous round was the best so far for either boxer, and it clearly went to Steve Bendall. Tried to staunch the bleeding on Mitchell's nose, but Bendall's opened up again and the blood is beginning to flow once more from Mitchell's nose. Trying to take it to Bendall this time. Mitchell, a little bit of a change of tactics, as Conor has said, listen, there's no point standing off this guy if he's going to start unloading like that. Let's try and take it to him a little bit more. That, however, is easier said than done.
Absolutely, you've got to get inside Bendall somehow. You've got to get away from all of his workspace, and that means getting close to his chin, making the fight ugly, but also making yourself less of a target.
Oh, good punches downstairs, great right upstairs, and Mitchell in trouble once again. Referee Mark Green having a very close look again. Good work, he banged away downstairs, then switched upstairs. He's developed that, Steve Bendall, as we've been watching him over the last 12 months or so. I think this is his seventh contest this year. Again, right upstairs, left downstairs. Credit to Mitchell, he's hanging in there, but increasingly it's becoming an uphill battle into the last minute of this fifth round. Scheduled for 12, cut opened up underneath Bendall's right eye. It's not going to cause him too much of a problem unless it starts swelling, but unlikely to do so because it's bleeding. But a cut has opened up underneath his eye, and a nice little right that time as well from Mitchell. Right uppercut. Just smear it, trying to smear the blood away there, Bendall. Not troubling him, and he was very nearly smeared it back into his own eye. Last 10 seconds of round five.
He'll be able to feel something hot on his cheek, and he's trying to work out what it is. He's trying to work out. Well, I haven't been hit. I haven't been hit hard. I shouldn't be cut.
End of the round. The tap gloves again. But the end of that fifth round, some work to do there on Bendall's eye. There you can see the blood. It's not above his eye, so it's not very nasty at all. And it should be cleared up quite nicely, but it is a sign that if Mitchell comes forward, perhaps he can cause some damage. Chris Sanagar in the corner there, just working away on it. There's Bendall again, nicely in charge, working downstairs and up as well. Good work by Bendall.
Full control. I mean, you saw that there. I think that was actually after the cut, because he gets a little bit close.
Trying to cover up there, Mitchell upstairs, so Bendall switches downstairs, and as soon as his guard is down, he works up to the head again.
Seconds out, round six.
Sixth round, blood still coming from the right cheek of Bendall. They haven't stopped it there over in that corner. Crisp little left that time from Bendall. Blood still coming from Mitchell's nose. Good left. Sticking in well here, Mitchell. I mean, he goes down as a sort of journeyman type boxer, doesn't he? At 33 years of age, clearly he's got limited ambition, but he hasn't gone down under this barrage from Bendall, and he's stuck in there and come back reasonably well.
Well, loses a lot, but he's only been stopped, I think, twice, and that's an awful, you know, that's not a bad record, and that's what makes him such an attractive proposition for young, talented fighters. Yeah, 10 losses, and I think only two of them have been stoppages.
And good work from Bendall. Punches from both boxers there. Good right at the end from Bendall. Thank you. Mitchell just off balance for a moment there as he tried to throw. Bendall didn't follow up. Many seconds to go in this sixth round. Both men well conditioned. Steve Bendall, 27 years of age today, in the sky blue trunks. Peter Mitchell, his opponent from Southampton, 6 years older. The man comebacking after 2 years out of the ring. This is just his second contest since then. Nice left jab, which did get through there from Mitchell. Bendall has dominated from about round two onwards.
That hurt, that the little right uppercut there, lead uppercut underneath Mitchell's left elbow. Mitchell's left knee came off the floor by about 6 inches. That was a fearsome, hurtful little shot. And Bendall saw it as well.
Working downstairs again. Bendall, nice right uppercut again from Bendall. He's got his man in the neutral corner. Good work from Bendall. Good right from Bendall. Another good right from Bendall. Mitchell really not offering too much just at this moment. He's just going backwards, trying to parry, trying to stay out of as much trouble as he can. Bendall throwing the only big ones. When Mitchell does get through, as he did there, he certainly hasn't got the weight of punch that Bendall carries. Although he's not really a one-punch man, Bendall. Again. So the final round then. I'd have been a betting man. I might have put money on an inside the distance win for Bendall, but it still might happen that way. But certainly Mitchell's put up a great battle here, a great credit to him for that as well. Bendall trying to finish in style, but Mitchell standing up to him.
I think he's won in style. He's boxed a shutout at this stage, 7.5 rounds into the fight. And that's as much as you can do, certainly against a guy like Mitchell, who doesn't come to lose. He just happens to lose when he arrives.
Referee Green just having to separate them. A wry grin on the face of Mitchell. And he's down. He's finally tagged his man, Bendall, and Mitchell goes down. I think it was the left that did it. He more or less bundled him over with a cuffing right at the end. But a good combination, and just when Mitchell seemed destined to go all the way through without going onto the canvas, without being stopped, he's tagged. Good lights again here from Bendall, who pushes his man away, and Mitchell is going to have to draw on everything now to try to sustain it to the end of this round and the end of the contest as well, of course. Going for it, Bendall. The fans like it. You can hear what they think. A little right from Mitchell. Mitchell moving backwards and covering up at the moment. Good work again from Bendall. Good left, good right again. He was caught by one in between there. Just something he'll have to look at on the video. Can't be perfect, of course, all the time. Took the punch well, but the accuracy of punching from Bendall has been impressive, Steve.
Oh, throughout the fight, even when he's dropped the guy there, it's the last round. He's won every second of the fight. You can excuse him for steaming in wildly. He still didn't. He picked his shots. And that little episode there in the corner just above us, maybe 30 seconds ago, that was classic Bendall. Everything was right. Everything was from the right distance. I think this has been a terrific performance. I really do.
There it is, the end of the contest. They embrace one another. It was a game battle by Peter Mitchell, but no question at all about the result. And Steve Bendall improves his record, 11 fights, 11 wins now. And what a 27th birthday present for Steve Bendall, because that was a very good performance indeed by the former Coventry man who now lives in Bournemouth.
Pleasing. Made a few mistakes, falling in a bit too much with my shots, but good kid, durable kid, and he's been around a bit, so I knew it was going to be a hard night's work. But it's a good learning fight, very good learning fight.
So birthday boy Steve Bendall there, 11 fights now, 11 wins. Was he really tested there tonight, Julius, do you think?
He was. I was quite impressed with Mitchell, because Mitchell done well to survive the attacks that he was under, to survive the pressure he was under. Bendall seemed to me to... I was very impressed with his the variety of punches that he throws. Uppercuts, hooks, straight punches, very good. And if there's only one, if there's ever one criticism I've got of him, it's just his slight lack of defence.
Let's pick it up in the fourth round, because as you were saying, I guess he thought that Mitchell was going to be someone he could finish off early on.
Yeah, he could. Here he took a series of really very telling punches. You know what I'm saying? He took a lot of coming from the southpaw, his right hand. Which is his lead hand.
Not easy, is it?
It's not easy for an orthodox fighter to get out of the way of these punches, but he took four very good, solid, right on the chin, very good punches. And Mitchell done very well to survive that in the fourth round.
We've seen a lot of Bendall on this programme. We've often said, he needed to keep stepping up a gear. But
I think definitely.
Mitchell in the end, we thought he'd gone in the sixth round. I think in the sixth, again, he was up against the ropes and he was standing.
He was under a lot of pressure.
And he was under a variety of shots at this stage.
Again, he was under pressure. And all the time he was fighting, but it just seemed like every time that Mitchell stepped up, Bendall would go back straight at him with a very good lot of concussive punches, and I was very impressed with him.
And then we got the knockdown in the eighth.
In the eighth round, it was a very good shot.
It was a very good shot,
and Mitchell done well to get up from it.
He did, actually.
He came through with a body shot, and then he came through again with a... he's left. Mm.
Mitchell might be a bit of a journeyman. He's only been stopped twice, apparently. So, he's not going to go down easily, is he?
For Mitchell, it was a tough fight, but for Bendall, it was a very good learning fight. He needs these kind of opponents if he's going to step up. He needs about another four or five fights like this, and then he can start challenging for titles. Because
how would you rate him against some of our top fighters?
Against the top fighters, I don't think he's really in that class at the moment. But you know, for Southern Area, challenging for a Southern Area title, which is it's a good step. A Southern Area, maybe a shot at a British title or a British title eliminator. There's some good guys out there that he can fight, and maybe in about four or five fights time, that would be the direction that he needs to have some good fights to learn, and that would be the good direction.
He's certainly someone to watch out for.
Yeah, definitely.
And they'll be very happy with
I was quite impressed with him.
You know, on the South Coast tonight, so good for you, and a happy birthday to him as well.